First, the foam sheets are cut into ski-width strips and then fused together using a steel plate heated to 500 degrees Celsius. This long strip is then cut into rough wedges, which are passed through a precision lathe to grind and polish them into shape. It's accurate to within a hundredth of a millimeter. That's a fifth of the thickness of a human hair. Each foam core is reinforced with carbon fiber and sheathed in a fiberglass sock. The outer covering, or cap, is prepared separately. The cap is exposed to the elements, so to protect the paintwork and logos, the design is printed on the underside of a thin sheet of plexiglass. A flash of UV light is then used to harden the ink. The outer cap protects the core of the ski from punctures and stops any water from getting in. The next challenge is to combine the core and the outer cap together into one whole ski. And that's done using this high-tech sandwich maker, a ski press. First, the outer cap is placed in the mould, face down. Then the foam core is combined with two more layers of carbon fibre. This tape is only 0.1 of a millimetre thick, but carbon fibre is one of the world's strongest materials. Before it's placed on the ski press, fiberglass strands are wound along the core to add strength and stiffness. The all-important base layer comes last. It's made from high-performance polyethylene, one of the toughest thermoplastics on the market. When all the layers have been assembled, the sandwich maker is shut tight. Hot water is then pumped through the mould, distributing the glue that binds the whole thing together. But a perfectly flat ski is less efficient than a curved one, so that's where this set of Frankenstein's neck bolts come in. Vidar Igelschön adjusts them individually to create the exact camber of the ski.
Så med de skruene her kan jeg justere hele skia, helt fra tuppen og tilbake. Skruer jeg ned framme, så lager jeg mer sprik på skiene.
The ski sandwich takes about 15 minutes to harden before cold water is pumped through to cool it down. It's still far from finished, however. Getting high performance calls for a long and involved manicure. First, the ends are cut roughly with a regular bandsaw. Then the ski is passed between a set of roller knives that lop off the excess edging. The tail is then precisely clipped with a laser-guided saw. And both ends are milled to give them their final shape. After all the layering, cutting and grinding, it's time to meet the robots. Their challenge is to fit the last vital component, a platform for the bindings. In the past, they were screwed in, but the holes tended to enlarge and crack over time. So the designers here invented a flexible plate system, which allows each skier to mount their own bindings without any permanent fixing. To prevent it shaking free in action, it's attached using a vibration-absorbing elastic glue. The skis have been manufactured singly. Now it's time to finally pair them up. This is where an experienced eye still has the edge over a robotic rival. Here at Quality Control, the skis are matched and checked for flaws. Those that pass muster are given paired serial numbers to ensure they stick together and then sent on for yet another polish. But they're not ready quite yet to hit the snow. The problem is, perfectly smooth skis don't glide properly. So this machine grinds very fine lines into the base to create a microscopic layer of water between the ski and the snow